Hey everyone, it's Carissa at Sprinkled with Glitter. Thanks for joining me today. Today I'm creating several cards featuring the Lawn Fawn Double Slider Surprise Die Set. I love this die set because not only does it create a fun, interactive card, but there's some great basic shapes that are included in the die set as well. There's this banner, which I love so much, and there's also a little tag. There are some pull tabs that you can use for different types of cards. And I'm going to be combining this die set with the Thanks a Latte stamp set, which I think is so much fun. If you know me, you know that I love my coffee. So I had to have this stamp set as well. Now I'm going to start out by just clipping my dies apart. I'm using some die snips here. These work really great. Be careful when you are snipping these apart because those little metal things that stick out from the side, they are sharp. And I did happen to stab myself with one. I've also stepped on one in the craft room, so just be careful. Now I'm going to start my die cutting now that I have all of my dies snipped apart. And this is the track piece that I'm laying down on some cardstock here. I also have kind of the outer pocket piece there on the right-hand side. And then this slider card piece. Now I am using my full-size Gemini for this today, but you do not need to do that. You can absolutely use the Gemini Junior or the Big Shot die cutting machine, whatever you have. I'm just trying to cut as many of these as possible at the same time. And I didn't cut down my 8.5 by 11 cardstock. So that's another reason that I'm using the full-size die cutting machine here. So now that all of my die cutting is done, I'm going to start by kind of just folding up these score lines on the outer pocket piece. I find that if you fold them the wrong way first to get the fold going and then fold it back the correct way, that works the best. So if you fold into the score line first and then away from the score line, I find that works really well. And now I'm going to start working on the assembly of this piece. Now, just because it's an interactive card, don't let that frighten you or scare you or intimidate you. The first time you're going to be kind of exploring really how to put this together as you have it in your hands. But after you put one together, it really comes together very easily. So I have my track piece here and I have some 1/8 inch score tape and I'm putting that along all four pieces of this track where it's up at the top. So I'm doing it on the top and the bottom of that track piece. It kind of makes like an H shape here. So I'm putting it on those lines that kind of extend out. So I'm doing that on both the front and the back of this track piece. Now, before I add adhesive to these pocket pieces, I'm going to cut a little tab inside of those. So if you take the bar of that die and you butt it right up against the edge of your pocket piece, it will perfectly position this little opening for kind of like a pull tab there. And I'm not going to actually add a tab to this, but I am going to have that open to where you can grab the inner card pieces much easier. Now to make this move, I need something plastic. Now Kelly from Lawn Fawn uses like dog poop bags. I just put aside some of the packaging from a couple of the stamp and die sets that I've purchased recently. And I'm putting this in my trimmer and just cutting off the seams where this is all connected. So when I turn this here, I'm left with just one seam connecting the front and the back, and it's on the right-hand side right now. I'm going to put this in my trimmer and I'm going to trim at 2.25 inches. And this gives me two pieces to create two separate sliders. I'm going to set one of those aside. And on this piece I'm working on, I'm going to take that 1/8 inch score tape again and I'm going to add it just to that edge there. And I'm going to position this onto the track piece. And I'm just using a little delicate surface painter's tape to hold that in place so I'm not trying to kind of fuss with it. And then I will remove the backer from the score tape and I'm going to take that bit of stamp packaging that I've cut into a strip and I'm going to wrap it around this track piece. Now I'm going to pull it, but I am not pulling it tight. It's kind of a delicate balance. You don't want it too tight and you don't want it kind of gaping and too loose. But I think as you play with it just a little, it'll kind of make sense to you. I feel like things, once you get them in your hands, they make a little more sense. It's a little easier to kind of figure it all out. And now that I know that this is moving well around that track piece, I'm gonna just trim off the excess of that packaging that was kind of overhanging where it was adhered. Now, if I was looking at this like kind of head on, I would have the seam of that on my left-hand side there. So I've put some score tape over that seam. And now I'm flipping it over to the back and I'm adding some more score tape on that plastic loop on the right-hand side. So on the front side, it's on the left-hand side covering that seam. And on the back side, it's on the right-hand side. Then I'm just gonna remove the backer from that score tape and I'm gonna take this card piece and I'm lining it up with the outer edge of this track piece. And I'm kind of using my grid mat to help me along in this process. And I'm just making sure that I have that on there nice and straight. And then I will push that down onto the adhesive that's on the left portion of this plastic loop that's already adhered onto my track piece. So now I'm flipping this over and I'm looking at the back of my track piece. And I wanna make sure that the slider card piece is going to have the front facing the front of my track piece. So I'm actually looking at the back side of the slider card. And I removed the backer from that adhesive. And this time I'm lining the edge of that card up with the edge of the track piece on the left-hand side. So now I have both of these card pieces that are gonna slide adhered to that plastic loop that's on the track piece. And as the recipient pulls on one of those cards, they're both going to kind of slide out. So it's really fun. Now we need to put together the pocket that's going to kind of cover all of these mechanisms. So I have both of these pocket pieces. I have two of them die cut here. I'm going to add adhesive to that tab that's on the right-hand side. And I'm gonna do that to both pieces. And I'm gonna use that score tape to adhere these together to create one continuous piece. So once I have the score tape in place, I'm going to remove the backer from this one on the left-hand side. I'm going to push them together. I'm gonna make sure that they're lined up. And then I am going to just push that tab down to adhere these together to make one long piece. So this is how it's gonna close up, but before I close it up, I need to put that entire sliding track mechanism inside of this pocket. And I'm just taking my bone folder to reinforce the folds on this and make sure everything's nice and crisp. So I'm gonna remove the backer from one side of this slider track piece. The part that is exposed is actually facing away from me right now. And I'm just kind of laying that into the pocket piece and pressing that down. Then I'm going to remove the backer from the adhesive on the front side of this track portion. I'm gonna fold down the flap from that pocket portion right over the top of that slider track on the top. Then I'm gonna remove the adhesive from that tab and I'm gonna press this down and this seals it all inside of that pocket. And now I have my double slider surprise interactive element ready to go on the front of my card. And I have to tell you, this is so much fun to play with. I must have wasted a ton of time playing with this mechanism here. I think it is so much fun. And like I said, the first time that you put it together, you're kind of fumbling your way through it. But once I had one in my hands and I had put it together, it was much easier to put together subsequent double slider surprise mechanisms. Now it's time to stamp some images out from the Thanks a Latte stamp set. I'm using the Gina K Amalgam Ink in Jet Black to stamp these onto some Nina Solar White cardstock. This is 110-pound cardstock. I've just really enjoyed the 110-pound heavyweight cardstock recently. And I'm stamping a bunch of these images out and I'm going to use my Copic markers to color them. Now I did skip all the coloring here. I have all the colors listed over at my blog that I used and they're on this paper here. And before I die cut these out, I'm gonna add some stuff inside of my mugs. So you can use this little line to create coffee or hot chocolate or tea. This one has some marshmallows floating in it, and I think it is so much fun. And it's really easy to line those up inside of the cup. So now I've used the coordinating dies to die cut all of my elements here, and I'm ready to put some cards together. Now I've used these images to create both kind of an everyday thanks a latte card here, and I've also created some holiday versions. So I'm going to walk you through the everyday version, and then I'll show you the holiday ones at the end as well. And like I said, for Copic colors that I used on all of these mugs, you can head on over to my blog. I will have them all listed out there. I'm starting with some kind of light aqua minty cardstock, and I'm backing it with some Stick-It adhesive. This is a really thin adhesive that die cuts really well. And I'm using these dies from the Lawn Fawn Big Scripty Words to die cut that minty cardstock. And I'm also using the banner piece from the Double Slider Surprise die set to die cut a banner here. And I'm just using my little pokey tool to poke those out of the dies. And once I have them die cut, I went ahead and stamped the greetings on top. So the first one says, thanks. I'm using kind of a dark gray ink here. The other one says, love ya. And so this is the coordinating stamp set that goes with that Big Scripty Words die set. Now I have those ready, and so I wanted to add a little bit of color. So I just cut down a piece of pattern paper from the Really Rainbow Petite 6x6 paper pad from Lawn Fawn. And now I'm starting to position all of my elements on top of this Double Slider Surprise mechanism that I've already assembled. So I'm just kind of decorating this. And in the end, I'm going to position this onto a card front. So now I'm going to go ahead and decorate this. On this top slider portion, I'm going to put a Starbucks gift card. I'm just making sure that I slide it in there behind that plastic loop that I created so that this doesn't interfere with the sliding mechanism. And I'm just testing that out to make sure everything works well. And then I'll add another mug, some whipped cream, and that Love Ya sentiment to this bottom slider card portion here. And I'm not using any foam adhesive on these that slide up into that pocket piece because I don't want that to interfere with any of the sliding mechanism. To finish off my card, I'm just using a little Tonic Nouveau Aqua Shimmer Pen on the marshmallows, on the whipped cream, and on these little hearts. And then I'm going to add a layer of glossy accents. I actually added two layers of glossy accents over the top of all of those, and it is so much fun. So you can see here, I've matted that with some more of that aqua cardstock, and I've put that entire thing onto a 4-bar size card base. So that measures 3.5 by 4 7/8. It's just kind of a fun mini size card. So that completes my cards for today featuring the new Lawn Fawn Double Slider Surprise die set and the Thanks a Latte stamp set. I think these products are so much fun. And in fact, I created a bunch of these slider mechanisms that I kind of put together in advance so that I would have them ready for holiday gift giving. These would be so much fun on the front of a tag, on the front of a card, on the front of a package, you name it. There are so many ways that you can use this. Now, I wanted to create a couple of these cards that could definitely be used for any occasion, but I could not resist those candy canes. So I made a couple of holiday versions as well, and I love the way this red is popping on these cards. I think it is so much fun and such a fun way to present a gift card. But keep in mind, you could also just use this to extend the scene on the front of your card as well. You don't have to necessarily include a gift card when you're using this Double Slider Surprise element. As always, I will have links to the featured supplies used in these projects in the description at YouTube, but head on over to my blog at sprinkledwithglitter.com. I will have that link below. Over there, I'll have more still shots, more information, and a complete list of supplies of the products used in these projects. Thanks for stopping by today. I hope you enjoyed these projects. If you did, be sure to give this video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss any of my paper crafting and card making video tutorials. Thanks for watching, and until next time, I hope you have a fabulous day.